Hello dear students, welcome to YouTube channel Learn with Gisela. In this video of number systems, we are going to study operations on real numbers, that is rational as well as irrational numbers. Now we are going to learn about mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division on real numbers. Before we move to mathematical operations, let us also study some important concepts related to commutative property, associative property and distributive property. These are very important properties and they are very helpful in solving the questions related to operations on real numbers. So let's get started. Now first of all, let us study about commutative property. The commutative property states that the numbers on which we operate, that means the numbers on which we do the mathematical operation, can be moved or swapped from their position without making any difference to their answer. That means we can change their position, we can change the position or the order of these numbers without changing their answer. Let me take an example. Suppose I take two numbers, 3 and 4. I use a mathematical operation, say plus, 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Now suppose I change the position of the numbers, 4 plus 3 is also equal to 7. So without changing the answer, I have changed the order of the numbers. I have changed the position of the numbers, but the answer remained the same. Now suppose let us take the case of multiplication. 3 into 4 is equal to 12. Even 4 into 3 is equal to 12. So even if I change the order of the numbers, the answer remains the same. So this is known as commutative property, where the numbers, if we operate on them and we change their position, the answer remains the same. So this property holds true only for addition and multiplication, but not for subtraction and division. Why so? Because suppose I take 4 minus 3, which is equal to 1. But suppose I change the position, I say 3 minus 4, which is equal to minus 1. Now over here I get a different answers. Here it is 1, here it is minus 1. Similarly, 3 by 4 is not equal to 4 by 3. Both are different. The moment I change the position of the numbers, the answer becomes different. Therefore, it is said if you move the position of the numbers in subtraction or division, it changes the entire problem. The answer itself gets changed. Now, therefore, if we have two numbers, say A and B, they are non-zero numbers. So the commutative property of addition says that A plus B is equal to B plus A. And commutative property of multiplication says that A into B is equal to B into A. So in short, we can say that commutative property, the numbers can be added or multiplied to each other with the in any order without changing the answer. So we can change the position, we can change the order of the numbers without changing the answer. This is known as commutative property. Now let us study about associative property. The associative property states that you can add or multiply regardless of how the numbers are grouped into brackets. That means regardless of how the numbers are put under the brackets or are grouped under the brackets, we can add or multiply them and get the same answer. By grouping, we mean how we use the parentheses. Parentheses again, types of brackets. In other words, if you are adding or multiplying, it doesn't matter where you put the parentheses. Let me take an example. Say 2 plus 3 plus 4. Now, if I put the bracket over here, 2 plus 3, 5, 5 plus 4, 9. Suppose, let me take another case where I'm putting the brackets over here. So 2 plus 3 plus 4, 7, again it is 9. So regardless of where I'm putting the brackets or regardless of how I'm grouping the numbers, my answer is same. Same is the case for multiplication. Suppose I take 2 into 3 in bracket into 4. 2 into 3, 6, 6 into 4, 24. Now 2 and 3 into 4 in bracket. 3 into 4, 12, 12 into 2, 24. Again, I get the same answer. So in case of addition or multiplication, regardless of how I have grouped the numbers, I will get the same answer. But this is not true for in the case of subtraction as well as division, because in case of subtraction and division we will get different answers. So this is applicable only for addition as well as multiplication. So this is known as associative property. So in simple terms we can say that associative property refers to the grouping of numbers. So basically we are regrouping the things, and the type of computation or the solution you can say depends on the numbers, how they are regrouped, right? So this is the associative property of addition. It says that a plus in bracket b plus c is equal to a plus b plus c. So a plus b in bracket, over here b plus c was in bracket, here a plus b. So however you group it, the answer remains the same. Associative property of multiplication says that a into b in bracket into c is equal to a into b plus b into c in bracket. So regardless of how you are putting the brackets or how you are grouping the numbers, the addition and multiplications are going to give you the same answer, but not in case of subtraction as well as division. We will get different answers in case of subtraction or division, right? So this is true only for addition and multiplication, associative property, right? Now let us study about distributive property. The distributive property tells us how to solve the expressions in the form of a in bracket b plus c. Now many times we have come across such expressions where we find it difficult to solve. So basically distributive property helps us in solving such expressions. It tells us the method to solve such expressions. It is also called distributive law of multiplication and division, because actually it breaks these complex problems into simpler parts, and then we are able to simplify it easily. So it's one of the most commonly used properties in mathematics. When you distribute something, you are dividing it into parts. So basically that is why this name is called distributive property, because when you are distributing something, you are dividing into two parts and then you are breaking it into simpler forms which are easy to calculate. So in maths, the distributive property helps simplify the difficult problems by breaking down the expressions into the sum or the difference of two numbers. Let me explain with the help of example. Suppose I take 2, in bracket I have 3 plus 4. Now this seems to be a complex problem for me. What I will do, I will take the outside number and I will multiply each with each of the numbers inside. So 2 into 3 plus 2 into 4, and I will get 2 into 3 is 6. 2 into 4 8, 6 plus 8 is 14. So this is how I have broken down this complex problem into two parts, right? Into the I have got the sum of two numbers and then I have simplified it. So it has become easy for me to do the calculations. So for expressions of the form a in bracket b plus c, the distributive property shows us how to solve them. So first of all, you have to multiply the number immediately which is outside the brackets with those which are inside, and then you have to add the products together. So first of all, you have to multiply a with b and a to c, ab, ac, and then add it. So this is how we use the distributive property, right? Now let us study about operations on real numbers. Real numbers can be rational numbers as well as irrational numbers. Rational numbers satisfy all the three properties, that is commutative, associative and distributive laws for addition and multiplication, which we have studied just now. Commutative, associative and distributive laws for addition as well as multiplication. So they satisfy all these properties. Now also, if we add, subtract, multiply or divide any two rational numbers, we will get a rational number. That means whatever mathematical operation we want to apply on the rational numbers, we can apply them and we will get rational number only. So this means that rational numbers are closed for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. That means they are closed for all the mathematical operations. But is it true for irrational numbers also? Let us see. So irrational numbers also satisfy the commutative, associative and distributive laws for addition and multiplication. However, the sum, that is the addition, difference, that is the subtraction, quotient, that is the division, and the product, that is the multiplication of irrational numbers, may or may not be irrational. That means we may get a rational number, we may get an irrational number. So that doesn't hold true for irrational numbers. That means the mathematical operations, if we apply on irrational numbers, we may get a rational number or we may get an irrational number. Whereas if we apply it on the rational numbers, we are surely to get a rational number, right? Now let us take up mathematical operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division on real numbers one by one. First of all, I have taken sum of two rational or irrational numbers. Various combinations I have taken with the help of example. Let us study them. 1 by 5 plus 2 by 7. So both are rational numbers. We have to find their sum. So 1 will be multiplied to 7 and 2 will be multiplied to 5. We shall get 7 plus 10 upon 35, which is equal to 17 by 35. So this is a rational number. So we can say the sum of two rational numbers is a rational number. Now take another example where we have taken irrational numbers and we have to find their sum. 2 minus root 7 plus root 7. Now minus root 7 and plus root 7 will cancel. We are left with 2, which is a rational number. So we can say the sum of two irrational numbers, we can get a rational number also. Now take for example another rational plus irrational. So rational plus irrational, we are getting 2 plus root 7. So basically we are getting an irrational number. So sum of rational plus irrational, we can say we are getting irrational number. Now next example, irrational plus irrational. So over here root 2 plus root 2, 5 is again a combination of an irrational number. So I can say the sum of irrational numbers, two irrational number, is an irrational number. So over here also we are getting an irrational number where we are adding rational plus irrational, irrational plus irrational, irrational. Over here irrational plus irrational, we were getting rational number. So we are not sure whether when we'll add the irrational numbers, we will get only irrational. We may get irrational numbers also. So accordingly, it can be said that the sum of two rational numbers is always a rational number, but the sum of two irrational numbers may be rational or irrational, right? Now let us study about the difference of the two rational or irrational numbers. Now let us take two rational numbers and find their difference. 5 minus 3 is equal to 2. That means if we subtract two rational numbers, we can get a rational number. 2 is a rational number. Now, two irrational numbers, if we subtract them, let us see what we are getting. So, 2 plus root 3 minus root 3, plus root 3 and minus root 3 will cancel. We are left with 2. That is a rational number. So, the difference of two irrational numbers, we are getting a rational number. Now, take the case of rational minus irrational. So 7 minus root 2, we will get 7 minus root 2, which is an irrational number. So difference of rational and irrational, we are getting irrational number. Now we take the case of irrational minus irrational. Let us study this. Root 5 minus root 2, again we are getting a combination of irrational numbers. So root 5 minus root 2, it is an irrational number. So over here, if we were subtracting two irrational numbers, we were getting rational number. Over here, if we are subtracting two irrational numbers, here we are getting irrational number. So we can say the difference of the two rational numbers is always rational number. And the difference of two irrational numbers may be rational or irrational numbers, right? So always the difference of rational numbers is always rational, but the difference of irrational may or may not be irrational. It may be rational, it may be irrational. Now let us take up next mathematical operation, that is product of two rational or irrational numbers. Let us take example of two rational numbers. So product of these two rational numbers, 5 into 3 is equal to 15. So we got a rational number. So product of two rational numbers, we got a rational number. Now let us take another example where we are having two irrational numbers. Root 3 into root 2 is equal to root 6, which is an irrational number. So product of two irrational number is an irrational number. Now let us take another example where we are taking two irrational numbers again, 2 plus root 3 and 2 minus root 3. Now they actually are similar to a plus b into a minus b. So here we can use algebraic identity 3, which says that a plus b into a minus b is a square minus b square. So accordingly we can write 2 square minus root 3 whole square. 2 square is 4 and root 3 is 3. So 4 minus 3 is equal to 1. So we can say product of two irrational numbers now is a rational number. So if you observe over here, two irrational numbers, the product was irrational number. Here the product of two irrational number is a rational number, right? Now let us take another example where we are having irrational number multiplied by rational number. So root 3 multiplied by 4, we get 4 root 3, which is an irrational number. So we can say product of irrational into rational is irrational number. So here we can conclude that the product of two rational numbers is always a rational number, but the product of two irrational numbers may be rational or irrational. We are not sure. We have to simplify it, solve it, and then we will come to know whether it is rational or irrational, right? Now let us move to the last mathematical operation, that is division of two rational numbers or irrational numbers. So first of all, I have taken two rational numbers, 5 by 3 divided by 7 by 11. Divide means multiply by the reciprocal. So 5 by 3 into 11 by 7. So 7 by 11 has become 11 by 7. Further, 5 into 11 is 55, 3 into 7 is 21. So I am getting a rational number 55 by 21. So I can say the division of two rational numbers, I will get a rational number. Now let us take example of two irrational numbers which are divided. So root 2 divided by root 3, I will get root of 2 by 3, so which is an irrational number. So over here, division of two irrational number, I am getting irrational number. Now let us take another example where I am taking two irrational numbers, 6 plus root 3 divided by 2 plus root 3. Now in this numerator, I can take 3 common. So I will be left in bracket 2 plus root 3. Over here I have divided by the denominator 2 plus root 3, which I can write like this also. Right, where this both will get cancelled and I am left with 3. So this is how this 3 came. So basically, when I am dividing two irrational numbers, I may get a rational number also. Like over here, the division of two irrational number, I was getting an irrational number. Over here, division of two irrational number, I am getting a rational number. Right. Now let us take another case of irrational divided by rational. So over here, I have taken root 3 divided by 5. So it is root 3 by 5, because further I cannot simplify. So I can say it is equal to irrational number. So division of an irrational number by a rational number, I am getting an irrational number. So I can conclude that the division of two rational numbers is always a rational number, and the division of two irrational numbers may be a rational or an irrational number. So after simplifying only, we will come to know whether after simplification, we are getting rational or irrational number. So this is it. With this, we come to end of this video. Hope you have understood all the properties as well as mathematical operations on real numbers. Thank you, children. Have a great day ahead.